part 4 in our management accountability series, where we're going to be talking about manufacturing companies. So the first thing I want us to be aware of, something we've already talked about, is the income statement for manufacturing company. If you will note, it is exactly the same as the income statement for the merchandising company. So we'll go through it another time really quickly here. We start out with sales revenue. Again, it's different from a service company, which has service revenue, because now we're selling a product. So we have sales revenue. We also have two contra revenue accounts called sales returns and allowances and sales discounts. Those effectively reduce our sales revenue to give us net sales revenue. From net sales revenue, we're going to subtract our cost of goods sold to give us gross profit. And from gross profit, we will subtract our operating expenses to give us our operating income. So again, the manufacturing income statement is exactly like the merchandiser's income statement. So let's look at product cost and inventory accounts for a manufacturing company. A manufacturing company uses three different costs to create a product. Those three costs are called direct materials, direct labor, and overhead. These three costs together, or those three costs combined, are called product cost. You also could hear them called inventoriable cost or manufacturing costs. So please be aware of that. In a manufacturing company, we do not have one single inventory account. We have three inventory accounts. The first inventory account is called materials. And this account is where all the materials that are used in production of a product are contained. The second inventory account is called work in process. This inventory account is where goods that are in the manufacturing process but not yet completed are located. Once a good is completed, it moves out of work in process into an account called finished goods. This account is where we have our completed goods that will stay there until they are sold. To give us a visual idea of this concept, let's look at the flow of cost. And we're going to use our three inventory accounts in the form of T accounts to see how these costs flow from one to the other. So again, these are inventory accounts, and they will have a normal debit balance, just like other assets do. So our beginning balances will be debits, and our ending will also be debit balances. When we purchase materials, that makes materials go up. So it's a debit to materials. Work in process, when materials are needed, will send a requisition, or they will requisition materials. And once they do, materials come out of our materials inventory account, and we call those used materials, and they go into work in process as direct materials. Now, there are other materials we'll talk about later that are called indirect materials. They do not go directly into process. So for our purposes right now, we're only talking about direct materials. In addition to materials, we will have direct labor in our work in process account, and we will have overhead. Remember, those three costs together are called product costs. Once we've completed a good, it comes out of work in process and moves into finished goods. This is called our cost of goods manufactured. Once the good is moved into finished goods, it remains in finished goods until the product is sold. Once the product is sold, we call that cost of goods sold. So one other thing I'd like for you to recognize is the difference in period cost and product cost. P period costs are expensed in the period they are incurred. So period costs are your operating expenses, your selling and admin expenses, and they are expensed when they are incurred. Product costs, our materials, labor, and overhead, they are not expensed until the product is sold. Once the product is sold, we call that cost of goods sold, and that's our expense.